Today we're going to think on Jesus, who is to us both a sacrifice for sin and also an example of godly life. And we ask God to give us grace enough that we may thankfully receive all the benefits that Jesus has given to us, and also enable us to daily endeavor to follow the blessed steps of his most holy life. That's our prayer. That's the collect for this day. And the epistle tells us wrongful suffering is not only thankworthy, but also what Christ did for us. So we're going to think first and foremost on suffering this day. What is it? Well, essentially, there are two types. First is the suffering inherent in life in this world, in this fallen world in which we find ourselves. That's called temporal suffering. Somebody punches you in the face for no apparent reason, or maybe you were in an argument and you said something really stupid or provocative that brought about the person's fist to meet your nose personally and powerfully. Or an auto accident, or a hurricane, or aging with its multitude of aches and pains. That's plain old temporal suffering. Or your house is burglarized. You see, there are so many different variations of temporal suffering. And that's not to discount the suffering. It may be quite intense. But as of yet, I've not given you any examples of wrongful suffering in accordance with the epistle for today. Wrongful suffering is what you must endure for the sake of the gospel, for the sake of your faith in Jesus Christ. And if you want to know specifically what that means, the first place you should look is to the account of the passion of Christ. What he experienced, you may also have to. You see, our calling is to follow the blessed steps of Christ's most holy life. That is to say, what we do and what we don't do. If we are truly following Jesus, there will be wrongful suffering that we'll have to endure. Now, where does that come from? Well, Jesus himself tells us. He said, "They shall lay their hands on you and persecute you, delivering you up to the synagogues and into the prisons, being brought before kings and rulers for my name's sake. And you shall be betrayed by parents and brethren and kinsfolk and friends. And some of you shall they cause to be put to death. And you shall be hated of all men for my name's sake. But there shall not a hair of your head perish. In your patience possess ye your souls." That's wrongful suffering. And it wasn't said by Christ merely to some guys a few thousand years ago. It's a message that endures to every Christian through all ages. Now, admittedly, your head will probably not be chopped off, nor will you be killed for the sake of the gospel, at least in these United States, but there are a lot of places in the world that are still killing Christians. But things like lawsuits, character assassinations, prosecutions, lies, idle talk flowing from the mouths of the godless are all part of the arsenal designed to weaken and destroy Christ within and also his church as a whole. And know this, when someone knocks the church or its people, it's normally done by an outsider. So much for suffering. Today is called Good Shepherd Sunday because of the gospel reading. Because the world is fallen and the forces of evil are strong, all we like sheep have gone astray. And yet, even when the hirelings all run away when the wolves of the world attack, the Good Shepherd is always near us, drawing us into his arms, in his loving embrace. The psalmist gives us a powerful testimony that we are never far from the helping hand of God himself. It's from the 139th Psalm, And it goes like this: whither shall I go then from thy spirit? Or whither shall I go then from thy presence? If I climb up into heaven, thou art there. If I go down into hell, thou art there also. If I take the wings of the morning and remain in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there also shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. The answer? Who? What is the answer? The Lord is our shepherd. We shall not want. Though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death with wrongful suffering on the left and the right and the top and the bottom, we will fear no evil, for God is with us. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. To follow Christ is to walk in his footsteps. This too, a world filled with sin and suffering and the devil, this too shall pass. It did for Christ, and it will for us also. See you next week.